I'm Robert Ashenall Sr. I'm from South Beach Tow, and you're watching me on American Towman TV.
Welcome to American Towman TV.
American Towman TV.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz. Wrecker manufacturers are constantly using customer feedback to design their next big product for the towing and recovery industry. Here's the story behind and the benefits of Jerr-Dan's new 50-ton rotator. Here's their heavy-duty sales and marketing manager with more. Take it away, Shane Coleman.
This is the 50-ton rotator that Jerr-Dan's come out with. The father to this truck would have been our 7085, which is known as the 85-ton Jerr-Dan. But the issues, as with any rotator that's been in the industry, is that rotators typically were too heavy to drive around every day. So then you start seeing other rotators in the market at different tonnages. But really, there's one basic number that really fits that need. Jerr-Dan feels that the 50-ton rotator fits that need. We have a truck behind us that's now legal on all axles, empty, which is new to the industry. Most of the other rotators were overweight on their drive axles to begin with. This is all stemmed from the responses from the operators saying, listen, I gotta go buy a permit every time I roll this truck out. I can't even take it out of my driveway unless I have a permit. Well, now they don't have to do that anymore. Our recovery boom on this unit is 41 feet, which is the longest one in its class. It has an elevation potential of 60 degrees. Okay, now when I say potential, I mean if there's an overhead obstruction, we actually had to lower it down a little bit in order to get it in the lights here. So there's some other features to it that, as we see on this side, is the spading option. The robust pins that we use to pin the cylinders, because the cylinders inside these were made just to get the outriggers in and out. We can pin these systems up to where we can create a spading option to allow this to plant itself. We have 27 inches of ability to plant this outrigger in for doing that side winch unit. So that eliminates the issues of stability when I have to just winch, because rotators, as easy as they are and as nice as they are to use, they're not always lifting and swinging the product. And I really have to give a lot of credit to the engineers that have come up with this, because they're the ones that drove this stability into this and the versatility, having the anchoring on the other side, which you've just seen, and then now we're on the stabilizing side. So seeing the surface area that we have, having both outriggers on the ground encompassing the turret, giving it its maximum stability, now I have another option. But when the operator shows up on the first job and he has to lift a load and move it to another trailer, like a load transfer as they know it, his next job may not be that. It may be a cement mixer stuck between two houses. Now, here's one last bit to this. Most of these frames are typically bolted to the truck frame, and a lot of that force is put on the truck frame. The difference in this torsion frame system is that only the truck chassis gets this unit to the job. All the forces that are put on these outriggers are put into that subframe, not on the truck frame itself. So it extends the life of the wrecker unit itself. So we not only think of the operator side, but we're also thinking of the business owner and the mechanics.
Thanks for watching American Towman TV, and stay safe out there.